Alright guys, welcome back to Spore. Now, it's one thing I need to point out that I did. I have the return ticket ability, which is you get from getting all the shaman parts. How did I get that? When we left off last time, I hadn't. What I did was, in between the last part and this, is I played an adventure that was really stupid. I played it just to get enough, barely enough points to get the final shaman part so I can get this. It was not either the ones that I plan on showing you, meaning it was not either the Shaman or the Trader Adventure. It was a user downloaded one that was really stupid. I did it because I wanted this, because what I want to do right now is explore a bunch of planets in the galaxy, and I want to be able to fly back home with ease. So what I'm doing right now is, yeah, the Manifestation of Darkness Empire. They are, zealots. Behold, I'm... Yeah, I don't, it's basically just a giant dragon's head. It's cool, I guess, I don't know. Maybe it's not cool, maybe it's very typical. Maybe I'm just imagining things, but I feel like the frame rate is much better while I'm recording right now than it was in the last few parts. Maybe I'm just used to watching the playback of the recordings. But let's go through this hole now. There might be a shaman or a thing, a Su'ul Empire. Two zealots right next to each other? The Bandit Empire. Wait! Oh. Ecologist. Oh, it's like a bandit! Literally a bandit from Mario games. Why would a bandit be a, ecologist? Hey, you're happy. Maybe you're a traitor, but you're probably a diplomat. Yeah, I'm mighty, and you are not, and they look like a typical alien-like creature, but it's cool-looking. So, yeah, how about, there were at least two more over here. How about you over here? The Ilu Empire. Another ecologist. Woo. There we go, it suddenly decided to work now. Yep, they're definitely ecologists because we think alike. But that was a cool looking creature as well. It's just a shame that I'm never going to interact with these people at all because they're useless to me. Ooh, I got the Explorer badge too. Well, there's no chance this will be either of the two. Another zealot. I'm mighty. Goodbye. They look like a spider looking thing. Are you a shaman or a traitor? The Squirm Empire. A scientist. Well, these guys are happy. The Oculus Empire. Yes! Traitor! Finally! Yes! I'm very, very, very happy right now. Alright, the Oculus Empire. They like meeting new people too, just like diplomats, because they like trading with people. They like selling things and buying things with people. That's their thing. Here's some prosperity. Here's some more prosperity. and that is an awesome looking creature. That is awesome, I have to say. Oh my, and look at this, they're already, look at it, because they love trading with people. Look how, just by selling them two items, it went up that high. I'm gonna make an ally with them. I have another question, but let's do a mission. Yes, an adventure. Guess we didn't save my favorite adventure for last, because this is my favorite adventure. I guess we're saving Shaman for last. Shaman is a good one, but it's definitely not my favorite. This one is my favorite. Where is the planet? Did I fly to the wrong one? I'm very confused now. I thought it just told me to fly to this solar system, but there was only one planet here. And a book of science, okay. I thought it said there was another treasure here. Was I wrong? Probably. I'm not crazy, I could have sworn it told me to fly to this solar system. It did! Oh, there's another planet over here. Oh. Okay. I understand now. Yes, the ruins of doom. You must find the golden llama. Let me enter. Let me blah, blah, blah. Let me put on the final shaman part on me. This last, it's honestly not that great, but I like the looks of it. What on earth can I get rid of, though? Let's get rid of this front thing, because I want to put it on his head as, like, a crown. Darn, what else can we get rid of? Let's get our knee pads. No, I like those, though. I do need to get rid of one more thing, though. How about your horns? That's enough. Yep. All right. Let's flip that completely around. And then we're gonna move it like this. And then we're gonna make it curl around like that. Yeah, what this does, it turns an enemy to your side for a short time. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, it's not amazing in any way. I just like the looks of it, and yeah, I might actually get rid of it. But who knows. But actually, for the moment, this is finalized. This is my finalized captain, because there's no really any more parts that I care to add. I mean, I could get more by doing more adventures, but if I ever did more adventures just to show you guys more for this, you know, just for fun, I would use a different captain, because this guy is not meant to be my super adventure captain. This is just meant to be the captain I use for this LP. Alright, let's beam down. This level is basically supposed to resemble like an Indiana Jones movie. We have to go into an ancient ruins and find a treasure and bring it back. Sounds very simple, right? Well, I just think this is an incredibly fun adventure, and the scenery and just everything about it is great. That's why this is my favorite adventure. And it's just fun. And this was actually the first one I ever did. When I first got the Galactic Adventures expansion pack, the first empire I met just happened to be a trader empire, and this was the first adventure I got. So it also has some memory things with me, but that has nothing to do with why it's my favorite. It's just a small tidbit I thought I'd share. Alright, let us recover the Golden Llama. Which is a hilarious thing that to call a treasure, but yeah. Alright, let us begin our adventure. Alright, now this is a collect adventure. Yeah, collect. It's literally like you walk into something and you pick it up. It's very simple and fun at the same time. And there are lots of little creatures that try to kill you, but they're not a problem because they only have 5 HP each. This isn't meant to be super challenging. Yeah, not really sure what to say, but there is something I want to point out, or something that I know about this adventure that some of you guys might not. You can break this wall, and there are gems behind it. Da-da-da! And I think you can break the other one, too. But yeah, it's supposed to symbolize you found all these gems, and you plugged them into this stone door, and then it lets you through. In reality, in the Adventure Creator, all it did was, this is what the door looks like. You had talked to the door, and now in the second act, the door is different and has gems in it. So, it's really interesting how you make adventures. That's all I was trying to say with that. Die. Maybe I shouldn't have gotten the freeze thing, because I feel like having strike is better in this adventure, but oh well. This is the last adventure that requires combat. The shaman adventure has none at all, so nothing, no need to worry about that. And I'm in trouble because there's an epic right here. I was killing that guy because he had a gem, but now that I think about it, I think I already grabbed the gem before I killed him, so there was no point. See, I could just snatch it out of his hand. Yeah, that was pointless trying to kill that guy. Yeah, but this is just why this adventure is so much fun to me. It's just really intense and action-packed and fun. Fun is the key word here. Why aren't you attacking him? See, look at this. Look at this crappy combat system. I've ranted enough about this combat system. I don't need two more, but it really needs work. Yep, we got to the next door. And the last collection is just, they're all in a line, so you don't have to, like, search for them. It's all, you just collect them on your way to the end. And then after you get to the end, you have to escape, and that is the funnest part of this adventure. And funnest is not a word, but I said it anyway. And Oh, that was a close one. My guy walks too fast sometimes. That's kind of... Actually, on my main captain, I actually only have level 4 speed on him because I dislike how fast you walk with level 5 speed. I mean, it's not bad. It's always nice being able to walk fast, but... Alright, here it is, the Golden Llama! And now we have to escape! Ah, giant monster! And then cue the epic music. Alright, we must get across the bridge, quick! And the bridge blew up. It's just so action-packed and awesome. That's why I like this adventure. Let's get out of here! And then something that is cool is the monster is right out here! Ah! Run! Sprint! Get away! And something that probably not a lot of people notice who play this adventure, that's not where you started. You actually started on top of that pyramid right over there. So this is... You didn't actually get back to where you started, but I bet they put it down here because they didn't want to make people have to climb the pyramid. But, yep, that is my favorite adventure of the Maxis Made ones. So, da-da-da! Keeper Aquablative in the Beautiful? Why did it give me that title? The Beautiful? Okay, I guess my guy is beautiful? I guess? I really don't understand why it gave me that title. Maybe it's... I don't understand. But... Yeah. Strange. Yay, no trouble at all. Now that I have money, can you charge my ship? Thank you very much, Oculos. Look at all the money I have just from selling them the two artifacts and for doing them a mission. While I'm here, I might as well look for a shaman as well. I got lucky with the traders here. Maybe there's a shaman. The Talon Empire. You can't be- This is a shaman! Yes! That was incredibly lucky! And that's a really cool creature as well. I'm not sure what it is, but it's really cool looking. Alright, let's do an adventure! Alright, this one is pretty fun. It's just very, very, very short. But it is definitely fun. Just because they did a really good job in this adventure. Oh, a treasure. They did a really good job in this adventure of scenery and environment. So. And after we do this, we have done every adventure, so we don't have to search for empires anymore. And another book of science. So when we're done with this adventure, I'm going to go back to my home planet and just do things that get me badges. But then at the same time, maybe I should be trying to get to the Galactic Center. And once again, I forgot to fly to the adventure planet. Because that is the main goal of the storyline, to get to the Galactic Center. I don't know if I actually care to get the Master Badge level 10. It really doesn't do much for you, except you can say that you got to level 10. And that you could have a 5-member fleet. That's about it. So, maybe I'll try to get to level 10, but maybe not. We'll have to see when we get closer to that point. But this is, I think, episode 17? 17 or 18, I think. Regardless, I don't want this to be over 20 parts, basically. Not including the bonus material. I am doing bonus material after we're done. I don't know when I'm going to do the bonus material, because I kind of want to focus on Black 2 when I finish this one. Thank the elders, you have arrived. Okay, the town gets attacked every night by these creatures called Shabbles, and we have to figure out why and how to stop them. Okay, as I was saying, I don't want this to be longer. I don't want the main playthrough of Spore to be more than 20 parts, so I guarantee you that will be the very last part if I get to 20. It could be finished sooner than that if we find a way to get to the Galactic Center quicker. But hello, something strange is up the hill. Follow me to the circle. Okay, just follow him. I really don't see the point of why they had made you have to do this, but all right, walk. Yeah. Look how slow he walk. Yeah. This is really annoying, but Easter Island heads. I wonder if Squidward lives in one of them. Oh wait, we're not underwater. Okay. Now we talk to him. Basically, this adventure is meant to be like a horror type thing. It's meant to just scare you. It's not hard at all, but it's very easy to think you're gonna die. And Yaden, I must bring the staff to the altar, and that will destroy the creature. But I have to walk the path of doom, and there's all these shambles everywhere. Look at they're all everywhere. These are the monsters that are terrifying the town. Better keep away from them. They will attack you if you run by them, but that's it. Their line of sight is very, very small. So that's why it's very unlikely you'll actually die. See, they're not even attacking me unless I, like, stand next to them. Watch. Hey, attack me. And if they do... Oh, they actually do take quite a lot of HP, don't they? Whoops. See, but basically, you have to, like, stop for them to do any damage. So if you just keep running and not get scared, you'll be fine. And then you walk in, and here's the end. It's the giant horror! He will start shooting at you if you don't destroy the altar quickly. So you just have to give the staff to it, and that's it. And I would just watch a scene of him blowing up. Bye-bye. And yay! That was it. That was literally the adventure. I bet some of you thought, why did you think this is such a good adventure? It's not one of my favorites. It's probably number four of all the adventures. My fourth favorite. First is Traitor. Two and three, it's a tie between Scientist and Zealot. And then four is this one. So, because it... Basically, I don't hate it, is why. I just thought the other ones, like the Ecologist and... What was the other one? Bard. Those were just boring. Oh, and Diplomat. That one's okay, too. This one's tied with Diplomat. And yay! That was the last Maxis main adventure, so... Until the bonus material, we are not doing anymore. Unless, of course, we decide to do a mission for a Empire and they happen to give us an adventure. That's the only other chance we will end up doing one. So, yay! Let's go back to Talon Empire. And they're super... Oh my god! That mission did a plus 60? I might as well give them ally me. Why not, right? It adds points to the ally badge or diplomat badge. Okay, I need to form three more alliances because I want the super happy ray. Why do I want it? Well, you guys will just have to wait and see. But I do want to make some more allies. And I know I passed by like a million diplomats on my way here. So if I go back the way I came, in theory, I should be able to find some and easily get allied with them. I'll just do a simple mission for them and get allies with them. So, I guess you can call this... These guys are diplomats. Let's make friends with them. The GG Empire. They look pretty cool. Yeah. Oh, wait. I want to save it before I ask them for a mission because I might not like what they give me. So, if I do like it, though, then I don't have to complain. But we will see. And this entire part will be skipped if I don't like what they do. I'm basically just going to keep restarting it until they give me something I like. Approval? A plant retrieval? Oh, this one's easy. Guess what? This is where my ecologist ability actually comes in handy. I need to go to Planet Priscursor. It's not on that one. So I basically have to explore all these planets to find it. Hey, treasure. Might as well look for treasure while I'm at it. Can't hurt, right? Money's always helpful. It looks weird, whatever it is. Oh, it's the bust of Yaman. Cool, I guess. Okay, I'm looking for planet Priscursor. Here's Priscursor. Let me show you how my ecologist ability will come in handy here. Just have to fly in. Press my Safari Vacuum ability, and... and I suck up one of every life form on this planet. Da-da-da! Well, I guess two of everything. Okay. Sweet, yep, I have it in my pocket now. I mean, sure, it wouldn't have been that hard to find. There was a radar telling me how to get to one, but still. So yeah, I basically just proved that the ecologist ability is basically worthless, because it was not hard to find. And look at that, another plus 60! After a while, does, like, doing missions give you more points than usual? Because that's weird. Alright, made one more ally, two more, and I'm two more, and I get the super happy ray. What, seeing as you have enough help when I, oh. I was just going here so I can see where their planet is. Was there another diplomat over here? No, and no. I can tell because none of them are happy. And I know that if I see one that I've met already and they're happy, I know they're a diplomat because the only two archetypes that can be happy when you first meet them are diplomats and traitors, and the only one traitor I've met was Oculos, so, yeah. We are now here. These guys are, oh, shy guys? Oh, no, bandits, I mean, those were ecologists. I was wrong, ecologists are also happy because they think like me. What wormhole did I come from? I'll try this one. If it's the wrong way, who cares? What? I don't care. I have the return ticket. I can get back home whenever the heck I want. I might as well just explore the galaxy. Nothing wrong with exploring the galaxy. Where am I? Haven't been here before, so this was the wrong way. But that's okay, because we'll meet new empires. Or at least, in theory, we will. These are some nice planets. But I'd never visit them, though, because I never come here. Oh, there's a treasure there. And no, never mind. It's not treasure, it's pirates. Die! Die! Bye-bye. Wait a minute. Someone had that ship already. I have a million ships downloaded in my Spore PD. Why would I pick the same one twice? That's stupid. Whatever. There's someone living here, and it's not a diplomat. New range? That's one of my creatures. And they're a scientist. I don't care to see New Orange. I know what he looks like. Hey, he's just a little orange alien thing. Anyone else over here? How many more people do I need to meet to get more traveler badge? I need to meet 25 more empires. Oh, these guys are happy. They're either a traitor or a diplomat. Either way, the Black Widow Empire. They're traitors. Of course I'm going to find a ton of traitors now. So the Black Widow Empire likes money. Interesting. Science! I forgot to sell the science books to the science man. Let me buy some colonies while I'm at it, because I might find some things that I'd want. That's a Black Widow? Okay, that looks really weird, but it's really cool, I have to say. Okay. Oh, they're already like me! Look at that! Let's ally with them while we're at it. Who cares? And there's a treasure here. Let me first ally with them. Because look at what... Traders love trading. They will love it if you buy and sell things from them. Perhaps an alliance. Yeah, I'm pumped. This is going to be epic. I think I just need to need one more. And then I can buy the super... Yep, and I can buy the super heavy ray. And I'll go home and buy it from my main diplomat allies. which is the Cradley Empire. Yeah. Treasure, 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 treasure. It is. What is it? Block of chance. Oh, I'll sell that back. Ango, back at home. Yeah, that's what I'll do. What was I gonna do? I was gonna look for more people to ally with. Is that what I was gonna do? No, I was gonna sell something to the Nurinj. Zazanero. And, oh, these guys are bards. Might as well sell the bard things to them. Why not? Yeah, block of chance to them. Oh, what is that thing? I want to see what they look like. What the heck is that thing? That's creepy. I don't like that thing. I'm not going to get rid of it because it is a well-made creature, so... Okay, I'm going to fly back home. And then I'm going to end this part. Because once again, I've been recording a while and feel like I've done nothing. But I'm going to go back home, I'm going to do a spice run, and then... Well, I'll do the spice run between this part and the next. Because you don't need to see that. So, I'll show you guys what the return ticket ability looks like. A black hole appears, it sucks you up, and you appear back at the home planet. Da-da-da! Welcome home. So yeah, that was that. Yeah. Hope you all enjoyed this part, and look forward to the next part, where hopefully we will reach at least the vicinity of the center of the galaxy. Not necessarily the center, but the vicinity of it. So yeah, hope you enjoyed, and of course, rock on.